Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. Okay. Let's look at this reporter. And then I guess talk to him. I guess he's the only new thing going on here. Yeah.
That's the reporter who let the council leader dictate tomorrow's news to him. If I've ever seen a frustrated man, Fox, then it's him.
Right. We did see him up top. Well, how you doing?
excuse me.
Oh, weather vane, right?
You know me?
The leader of the council asked me to have a snoop around in your past. Find some dirty laundry. Nothing!
My mage's cape is still brand new. I got it when I became a professor. Do you like it?
Very fetchy. Why are you disturbing my quiet drink?
Why not?
I have a couple of questions.
You have to talk to everybody, you know.
A couple?
Well, I saw you with the leader of the council up there by the lottery barrel.
I saw you up there. At the lottery drum. Council leader Van Buren was there too.
Not one of my greatest moments. Letting a politician tell me what I should write about her.
So why do it then?
You can't drink integrity. Anyway, it's fantastic being able to influence so many people's opinions. What I write becomes a big issue of the day, you know?
You don't seem very happy.
I get the feeling you're not very happy.
Really? Why shouldn't I be? I've always got enough liquor in my belly, and I've never earned as much gold as I have this past year. I spent it on women, alcohol, and fast horses. I just frittered the rest away. I simply must be happy.
But yet... Why do you always drink from the same glass?
I noticed that you're always drinking from that same glass.
So?
Shouldn't the glass eventually be empty?
It's a magic glass. Sloth came up with it. He didn't want to keep bringing me new glasses, and I didn't want to keep waiting for the next drink. So he magically connected the glass with one of the barrels behind the bar. A win-win situation.
Interesting. So, you're the editor of the Seastone Lookout, right, Mr.
You're the editor of the Seastone Lookout, right, Mr.
Fox. Archibald Fox.
Your name is really Fox.
You got a problem with that?
No.
Isn't that a little unimaginative? You are a fox, and your name is Fox.
That's just how it is.
That gets confusing at family gatherings.
Everyone's a critic nowadays.
So what are you writing about at the moment?
What are you writing at the moment?
An article for tomorrow's edition. Pet dragon attacks on the rise. Child mauled.
How does that sound? That's terrible. Is the child okay?
Ah, don't worry. The kid is as made up. That's the problem with pet dragons.
But then why write about it?
In the obvious, the Archmage simply doesn't do enough about the pet dragon problem.
But I thought that there wasn't one.
The leader of the council has now picked up the issue and has finally enacted a law strictly regulating the keeping of pet dragons. Everyone wins. My newspaper, because it reported on this urgent problem first. The leader of the council, because she acted quickly and decisively.
What about the Archmage?
And the citizens, because they don't have to worry about pet dragons anymore. Are you worried about pet dragons?
No.
You see, all thanks to Mrs. Van Buren.
Well, I think I've got a story for you. as if you'd really report on anything that's true.
I think I have a story for you, a real story.
Yeah?
As we speak, the captain of the town guard and a notorious merchant are negotiating bribes. What do you say to that?
I'm shocked.
No, seriously. Bill smuggles alcohol into the lower town, bypassing customs. Mr. Shieldhand knows about it and wants a bribe.
Well, but let me explain.
Mr. Fox, you're a reporter. It's your duty to report on things like this. Do you know why you feel so lousy? Because you're a bloodhound. Fox. Because you're a blood fox.
A blood
you
fox.
You don't just make up stories and have propaganda dictated to you. You want to investigate. You want to uncover. You want to expose.
Ah, all right then. Come and see how this old fox sorts things out.
Fabulous. There's just one problem. Those two are in the upper town and the gate is closed.
I'm a reporter. I can go anywhere.
Okay, we'll see about that.
That's nonsense. If I gave you a gold piece for every barrel, I'd only be making 6 gold pieces profit on 3 gold pieces outlay. I may as well play tax.
I want my share. Nothing happens around here without my share.
Good evening, gentlemen.
And now him too.
What's that I hear? Exorbitant prices being charged for alcohol? And this alcohol is being smuggled past customs into the lower town?
I was just in the process of clearing up the affair.
What do you want, Fox? Push off. We've got business to do.
That's why I'm here. I want to show my young friend over there how business is done in this town.
He wants some...
Exactly. That's why we have laws, you know?
He wants a cut of it too?
Right. Well, according to the law, Bill would have to forego lots of money, Shieldhand would be out of a job, and the little influence he has, and I would be worried about the alcohol supply chain.
So what do you propose instead?
I get my alcohol at the normal price from now on. No more daylight robbery for the old folks. Bill, you continue using your crane, saving you on customs. Our competent Captain Shieldhand here is then entitled to part of the savings. I save gold, you continue to earn more than you're entitled to, and Shieldhand makes a bit on the side. We all win. How does that sound?
I don't think Wilbur's going to like it.
But...
Sounds fair to me.
All right.
Ah, then we've got a deal. Come on, Shieldhand. This is cause for celebration. You see, little Wilbur here could clearly see that the situation was unsustainable. An arrangement which made you money suddenly leaving you empty-handed? Can't have that.
Thank you, Weathervane. Perhaps I was wrong about you.
But.
Here, with this, you can get from the lower town to the upper town any time. You've earned it.
But we didn't do anything.
This is the world I helped build. Rather than toppling it, I've become one of its pillars. That's the reason I'm not happy.
Huh. What are you looking at us for, Wilbur?
The key for the gate between the upper and lower town. A small glass with a mark, a 2CL.
Yeah, we need that for ingredients. So, Bill.
Hello, Bill.
Wilbur.
So you continue to avoid paying duty?
So now you can just keep on smuggling your alcohol without worry.
Thanks to you. It was a mistake depriving Shieldhand of his cut. One hand washes the other, and in the end, everyone's got more gold in their pockets. The system works.
Oh, by the way, can you tell me how much 12 teen is?
You're pretty good at numbers and measurements.
I'd say.
Can you tell me how much 12 teen is?
12 is a forgotten number, between 12 and 13.
Really?
In the past, people counted more precisely, so there were a few extra numbers. Thor and 12, for example.
Thor?
But I have to add exactly 12 drops of dragon sweat to a potion.
Oh, exactly 12. Well, that's something else completely. That's what mages always write if they don't really know themselves exactly how much of something they need. They don't want to admit it, and it sounds cleverer if they say exactly 12 rather than it doesn't really matter. But you should know that as a mage.
Oh, well, do you have crocodile tears?
Do you sell crocodile tears?
Can order them. Be here in 3.
Ah, that's too late.
Oh, the fine sir wants free overnight delivery, does he?
Hmm. Yeah, you got FedEx. Now, I don't know, are they actually tears from crocodiles, or are they fake tears, like crocodile tears?
Do you sell crocodile tears?
Same thing, right?
You can order them.
Ah. Oh.
Do you happen to sell dragon sweat?
Do you sell dragon sweat?
Doubt it.
Dragon sweat? That's very expensive.
I was afraid of that, but I need it badly.
I mean expensive, like I'll give you half of my kingdom and my prettiest daughter. Even you can't afford that.
Hmm, too bad.
Hmm. Well, then, in that case, I've got
to
go.
I have to be going, Bill. See you next time.
See ya.
Let's go back down. Let's talk to our friend here. X. Glug glug, X.
Hello? X?
Shh. What do you want?
Everything. Your jacket is still hanging up in the tavern.
Sloth, the inn's landlord, said you were arrested because you didn't want to let Mr. Shieldhand search you.
And why should I? I haven't done anything wrong. He knew I was one of the protesters. He just wanted an excuse to lock me up.
Hmm. The protesters behind the barricade said something about a hand sign. Do you know that?
If you're one of the protesters, then you'd have to know their secret hand signal, right?
Yeah.
Can you show it to me?
Ha! So you can tell them what it is.
No! I need it, and I'm one of you.
Then you must know the signal yourself.
Of course I do.
Yeah? Then do it for me. Do the secret signal.
I just asked you to do it. You first.
No problem, but you first.
What's all that about?
I don't know if you're one of us. Besides, you've been in prison for quite a while, and maybe they brainwashed you.
Hmm. All right. Now you. You are one of us.
I just copied what you did. So was the hand sign again?
Is that really you, X?
Yeah.
Do the signal. Okay, then.
Do we have to, like, note this? Am I gonna have to do this?
Is that really you, X?
Yeah.
Do the signal.
2, 5, 2, something like that.
Okay, then.
How to write it out. Okay. The other protesters spoke about a cake.
They were saying something about a cake at the barricade?
Yeah, great work. I wanted a file to free myself. What did those geniuses send me? A bloody chisel.
Well, it's the thought that counts.
Perhaps if they'd hidden a hammer in the cake as well? I shall be bringing that up at the next group meeting, numpties.
Numpties? Can I have the chisel?
I need the chisel. Can you lend it to me?
What do you need it for?
None of your business. I want to help you escape.
Maybe. I could use it to help you escape.
Doesn't sound bad. But how about you think up a plan first, and then I give you the chisel?
Well, about the chisel.
About your chisel?
Yes.
I might have the right hammer for it.
Really? That'd be good.
Right, we do have a hammer.
Yes, but...
You'll have to lend my the chisel first.
First, you'll have to lend me your chisel for a bit, and then I'll return it with the right type of hammer.
What if you don't? Perhaps the guard will catch you. Or you'll meet the love of your life while hammering and simply forget about me. Or perhaps you'll be appointed God of Thunder and sod off to Asgard.
Anything is possible, more or less. But I'll definitely bring you a perfectly matched hammer and chisel first.
Nah, too risky.
I'd have to know exactly what kind of hammer you want.
What type of hammer do you want?
Hey, what type of hammer? Just a hammer.
Oh, but there's a whole range of them. I lived with the dwarves for a long time and learned quite a bit about hammer technology. You could have a dwarven steelhead hammer,
oh God,
a common roundhead hammer, a war hammer, an MC hammer.
A dwarven steelhead hammer?
They had to go there, right?
Yeah, left or right-handed.
I just want to knock a few stones out of the wall.
Out of this wall? What kind of chisel have you got? When was it made? Oh, what type of alloy did they use?
I don't know.
Hammer and chisel have to be perfectly matched, you see. If they're not, well, things can get pretty ugly.
Really?
Yeah, it might create sparks.
You see, if the metal used in the hammer and chisel aren't compatible, every blow could cause sparks.
So, I don't care.
Not even when the straw in your cell starts to burn.
Ah. But I don't know what kind of chisel it is.
That's why you should always work with professionals. Give me the chisel, and I'll look for the right hammer.
Oh. Thanks.
Now that works. Kind of wish I chose the whole, you know, the whole building a cave in. All right, I gotta go.
Well then, I have to be going.
Take care of yourself, brother.
So they had to deliver a cake in order to give him this chisel. But he just passes it through the window to us.
A nickel-plated 2-inch, 300-gram flathead chisel. Right-handed.
Doesn't look like we can combine anything, right? They did want something. They wanted something from the bakery. Someone did.
There are the chocolate Sloth was talking about in the shop window.
Right.
2 sea stone small ounces of indulgence per chocolate, with and without alcohol. I wonder if Sloth would help me with a golem if I got him some chocolates.
What are you going to do? Some little break-in and entering?
There are the chocolate Sloth for 2... The drain's blocked by a grating, and even if I did remove it, I'd still be too big to climb down. The lookout is reporting unfairly, and someone has glued these fabrications about the Archmage to the wall. No wonder his lead in the polls is disappearing.
I think I've seen all
the
this,
lookout
right?
Is reporting... No.
Yeah. Mr. Shieldhand.
Mr. Shieldhand?
Mr. Professor.
I think it's scandalous you're in cahoots with Bill.
Do you think it's it's okay for you, as a captain of the city guard, to be taking bribes from a smuggler?
I don't know what you're talking about.
About your deal with Bill? Aha. He pays you not to look while he smuggles his alcohol past customs.
According to my information, the honourable traders of this town always pay the customs duty the town is due.
But
information to the contrary will, of course, be followed up resolutely by the town guard. We advocate stringent investigation in the case of bribery offences. That's always been our motto.
Yeah, well, you're not following it.
Have to be going.
Yeah.
Can you help this? Can we use this?
The knight doesn't seem to have legs anymore. But he does have two strong arms of stone that any golem would be happy to have.
If golems can be said to be happy.
The knight doesn't seem...
Can we chisel this thing away? Look like Mr. Shieldman.
I hope you're not about to damage town property.
We have to bribe him.
Me? Perish the thought.
That's good. Otherwise, I'd have to get up, go all the way over to where you are, and arrest you.
Oh, two whole steps.
Let's spare ourselves both the trouble, shall we?
The less I talk to him, the better.
Okay, so we bonk him over the head with the hammer. No. We chisel his face in? No.
Guess I've never really been interested in magic duels.
Yeah, I tried that before.
What can I do for you?
I might have some more questions for you later.
And I...
might answer. Well, I don't know what we can do here. Talk to these guys, I guess.
Yes?
Me again.
Do the secret sign.
Fine then.
So it's 252, something like that. Or 3? I think this is the last one. I think.
That wasn't right.
It's the other way around.
I know. I just wanted to test you. You passed. See you later. Darn it all to heck. That was not it.
It's the other way around.
Yes?
Me again.
Do the secret sign.
Fine then.
That wasn't right.
No?
I know. I just wanted to test you. You passed. See you later. Darn it all to heck. That was not it.
Damn.
And how exactly is the key to the town supposed to help me? I don't see a keyhole. Cool.
Chip. Right. All right. Let's get it.
Hello? X?
Shh. What do you want?
I want the sign, damn you.
Is that really you, X?
Yeah.
Do the signal.
Isn't it the same?
Okay, then.
Hold on.
Is that really you, X?
Yeah.
Do the signal.
It's like devil sign. Three devils. Oh. With the...
Okay, then.
Two with the thumb is the last one. Hold on. One more time.
Is that really you, X? Do the signal.
What's that middle one, though? Yeah.
Okay, then.
Okay.
Well, then.
Take.
Hello? Hopefully I get it right.
Yes?
Me again.
Do the secret sign.
Fine then.
This is the last one. I think it's this. And then this.
Aye, spot on.
Great.
I guess you really are one of us.
That's what I told you.
Here, take these. You can hang them up in the upper town.
What you got?
Posters? I'm really more interested in the clay.
Yeah. Here's some clay as well.
Oh, good. May this cloud of pure earth serve the good cause.
Oh, it will. So then this hole... That should keep out any poison gas. The rest of the clay is for the golem head.
Hmm. That'll work, huh?
A decent-sized lump of clay. Enough to sculpt the golem head.
Flaming protest posters.
Different posters from the protesters. Some denounce the council leader's policies, saying she only represents the interests of the rich and powerful. I guess if you protest against everything and everyone, every once in a while you'll end up hitting the bullseye.
Hmm. Alright, well, let's go put these posters then. We gotta find a way to distract Mr. Shieldhand or get him out of his post. So we can take the stuff here. Attach.
The protester's poster would be more effective there, but it won't stick without paste.
Oh, right. The mop with the troll spit.
Okay, troll spit isn't as sticky as troll snot. Maybe it'll do as a substitute for paste.
Either way, it's disgusting.
So...
Done.
Hand.
Mr. Professor.
There's a protest poster hanging up over there.
There's a protest poster on the notice board over there.
So?
It's against Council Leader Van Buren. What filth.
That's vandalism of the worst kind.
Is he distracted now? Can we do this?
Sorry, old friend.
Sweet.
still looks ready to fight.
That must be some chisel, huh?
Two beautiful strong stone arms for my golem. He'll like these. Hmm, right then. How should my golem look?
Cool. We get to make our little facey. What do you think, guys? I kind of like with the devil horns. I like that. This one. Done.
Oh yeah, that's the way I like it. Do it.
That's the way.
The eyes. I like yeah. it. Oh, the nose. Mmm. Oh, that's tricky.
Why are you
and
yelling?
Of course, not to forget the mouth opening. That's it. Perfect. Should blocking Van Buren manage to fire me, I think I'll turn sculptor or golem head designer.
Right. Nailed it.
My golem's head. It looks exactly the way I imagined it would. But I have to be careful. It needs bacon.
I'm gonna bake it now. So we're gonna bake it over this fire because we can't use that fire. For whatever reason. I'm pretty sure that clay sculptures aren't usually
but
baked
hey,
this way.
This is innovation.
I'm filling in the missing lines, guys. Right.
My golem's head, hard as rock and beautiful.
Okay, can we attach arms now?
In principle, they belong together. It's just that the torso in between is missing.
We're gonna find a golem torso. I don't know what I'm doing, guys. Don't mind me. Maybe they have something. I think the protesters meanwhile.
But they won't achieve much if all they do is make unrealistic demands and protest. They have to be the change they want to see in the world.
Missing pieces of dialogue. We need more updates to download. Alright, thanks for watching. See you next time and hopefully we finish this golem. We gotta find a torso somewhere. Oh, I think back in the school, actually. Yeah. Okay. Alright, see you next time. And a bang bang boogie and don't stop the boogie.